Going to be talking, giving you a brief on this horrific incident that occurred out here today. At 1 minute after 1 o'clock, officers received a call of a shooting at 321 Broadway. They arrived shortly after and found that two gunshot victims in the parking lot. Both victims were transported. One of the victims has been pronounced at the hospital. The other one is in surgery. A short time later, at approximately 1:06, the suspect was spotted. He was pointed out. The officers it was brought to their attention. The suspect was the one that was responsible for the shootings. An eyewitness that witnessed the shooting was able to point him out to officers. Officers were able to get that suspect into custody and has been transported down to the Denver Police Department. We are also looking for another individual that wasn't actually involved in the actual shooting, but is a person of interest that was with our suspect when they arrived here today. We're looking for the car that they arrived in, and we'd like any help from any citizen that spots this car that can give us a call and let us know. It's described as a silver Chrysler 200. Has some slight damage to the left front quarter panel. The plate number on it is a Colorado ALOI76. I'll repeat that, ALOI76. Any information we get to find this car would be of great help to us. Right now, there is no indication there's any connection between the victims and the suspect. We have determined that the victims were patrons of Enterprise and not employees. That pretty much is it. I'll open it up for any questions you have right now.
Some witnesses said they saw this shooter possibly throwing something out in a garbage can and running
around. Yeah, we're not going to get too much detail on that because that is an intimate part of our investigation, but as that develops, we'll be able to put more information out on that.
Can you explain where the suspect was spotted, and is that the reason why there's such a large crime scene?
Yes, so the suspect was spotted down at the end of the block and was taken into custody on the 400 block of Broadway.
Names of the suspect?
We can't put that out right now.
Race of the suspect?
We're not going to put that out right now. We still have some identification issues we've got to work through.
You mentioned they were at Enterprise. They were renting a car?
We do not know that. We just know they were not employees, so I don't want to speculate on what they were doing there, but they were not employees of the, but they were shot in the parking lot at Enterprise.
Do you mention they don't know each other, no?
There's no indication that they knew each other.
So suspects didn't work there, victims were customers?
We're assuming they were not employees, so they were in the lot. The assumption at this point is they were customers, and the suspect had no connection to Enterprise whatsoever.
People over here, Duncan, mentioned that a gentleman was pacing back and forth for like 15 minutes before he walked over to the Enterprise. Have you guys identified that person?
We have not. We're still sifting through several witnesses and looking for any type of video evidence on the block that we can look at and determine if there's any connection to that.
Do you understand why Enterprise was the target?
We do not at this point.
There is an employee of Enterprise who said his boss maybe had a gun up to his head, but he's okay. Was there anyone else injured?
No one else was injured. No, just the two.
Any reasons for the altercation?
Not at this point. We don't have a motive right now.
Did the suspect go in the building at all?
Not that I'm aware of. I don't know that much about that part of the investigation yet to give you an honest answer on that.
Were you after said this, but was the suspect seen walking out and then spotted like on the sidewalk or something?
The suspect was spotted as he left the lot. I don't know which direction. I can't really get into that right now.
He was pointed out by someone who witnessed it.
Yes.
When you apprehended the suspect, did you apprehend the weapon with him? Was it on the suspect?
We believe that we have the weapon that was responsible.
You said that the victims and the suspects may have had no connection. Should there be a warrant for the second person of interest?
I'm never going to rule that out. We know that person was not involved in this shooting, but they were together at some point. We have no idea whether or not they're armed or whether they're a danger to the community, so we want to get this person contacted as soon as possible.
Do you have any description of what that
person is? A female at this point, as we're getting some information, it's a female. If we get a race, I'll be able to share that with you shortly after. But
and you said Chrysler 200 or 300?
200.
Okay.
Can you repeat the number of
the plate?
Plate?
Yeah, it's ALOI76.
And again, the vehicle description is?
Chrysler 200, silver in color, has slight damage over the left front quarter panel.
What type of weapon was it?
I do not know that at this point.
I don't know how long you're going to have. This is Friday night. People try to get out of downtown. How long are you going to have Broadway closed?
As long as it takes us to process the scene, so I can't even speculate on that right now.
Did anyone see any kind of altercation, anything happening in the parking lot before the shooting happened?
Not that's been brought to our attention, but again, we have a lot of witnesses to talk to. With the apartments and everybody around here, I'm sure there's going to be other people that come forward and that saw some part of this.
Was that Chrysler that they're in? Is that a car that was through Enterprise or rental car?
No, it's not.
There was the shooting at Soul Tribe not too long ago. I live around here. I've seen some wild stuff just on Broadway, uh-huh, random people. Can you speak, is there an issue broadly with this area in town that you guys are dealing with?
I would not say that so much, just in general. As you know, it's no secret that, you know, gun violence is up throughout the metro area. I don't know that it's specific to one specific area. You know, it's really a sad time right now that there's so much violence going on with involving weapons. So I don't want to indicate that anything in connection with Broadway. And it's just, I know that too was a extremely terrible incident. So our hearts go out to the families, and our hearts go out to this community.
You think they're trying to steal a car or get money from Enterprise?
We do not know yet. We have no motive at this point. As we work through this investigation, we'll have better indication of why this happened.
The people renting, are they here from Denver?
I do not have that information right now.
Did you see how many shots were fired?
Not at this time, no.
Thank you, Chief.
Okay, thank you.
Chief, another question. The suspect was found inside a car or just...
No, on foot. On foot.
All right, thank you folks for tuning into Fox 31 Now. I'm Alex Rose. A lot more details than I was anticipating coming out of that press conference. Again, our thanks to Division Chief Joe Montoya for providing that update for you folks here on Fox 31 Now. So again, if you folks are just learning about this situation, a man is dead and a woman is critically injured following a shooting that happened in the middle of the day in an Enterprise rent-a-car parking lot right off of Broadway. This is around the area of 3rd and Broadway, and Broadway is still shut down as this is an active investigation. It's shut down on Broadway from 4th to 3rd. The shocking detail we learned in that press conference, again, it doesn't appear that the suspect and the victims knew each other, and it looks like, according to police, that the two victims were just shopping. At least that is what they believe at this time. They were just patrons of Enterprise Rent-A-Car when they were shot in the parking lot. So again, we know that a man was killed, a woman was critically injured. The shooting happened at 101, and then at 106, Denver police on scene, able to talk to a witness who identified the suspect a block away, and that suspect was put in cuffs and arrested and taken downtown. Now, here is the other caveat. Police are currently looking for a person of interest in this case, a woman. They didn't go as far as to label her a suspect, but they do believe that this woman, this person of interest, did arrive with the suspect of this shooting in a car. And so the information right there at the bottom of your screen, it is a silver Chrysler 200 with Colorado plates ALOI76. Again, that right there at the bottom of your screen, a silver Chrysler 200 with Colorado plates ALOI76. If you know any details about this shooting, if you see that car, you're encouraged to reach out to the Denver Police Department or with our partners at Metro Denver Crime Stoppers. You can leave an anonymous tip, and anything that is helpful for police in their investigation, it could allow you to be eligible for a reward. You can call them at 720-913-STOP. And so, again, a lot of confusion, a lot of people chiming in here on Facebook wondering why and how this thing could have happened right here in the middle of the day, just after 1 o'clock on a Friday. Again, with no connection between the suspect and the victims. And we are certainly wondering the same thing, and we are asking the same questions. You heard the voice of our Courtney Fromm, who was there at that press conference. She's on it for us. She's going to have more for us tonight on Fox 31 News at 4 o'clock and then again at 5 o'clock. So, again, that is the latest information from Denver Police. Thank you so much for tuning into Fox 31 Now. For one final time, I just do want to mention, because it's important to get this information out, that the investigation into this scene isn't wrapped up yet. Broadway is going to be shut down between 3rd and 4th for a good amount of time, and so you may need to avoid that area if you're trying to head home from working downtown. And again, police are looking for a woman, a person of interest in this case, who rolled up to the scene with the suspect. They don't believe that that woman was involved or actively involved in the shooting, but of course they would like to track that person down and ask them a couple of questions. They are looking for this car. It is a Silver Chrysler 200, Colorado plates ALOI76. And again, if you have any information, please pass that along to our partners at Metro Denver Crime Stoppers, leaving an anonymous tip by calling 720-913-STOP. If you have any questions, or if you are looking for more information on this breaking news story as it develops, you can check out our website, kdvr.com, and the Fox 31 app. That is where you're going to be able to get the latest information on this investigation. That's going to do it for me here on Fox 31 Now. I'm Alex Rose. Again, thank you so much for tuning in. Hope you folks have a great rest of your day. Take care. We'll be right back.